also through one man's righteous act, the free gift came to all men, resulting in justification of life. So in other words, one man, Adam, sinned, damned us all. One man, Jesus Christ, he obeyed unto death. Those who trusted him will not be condemned, but have everlasting life. That is the gospel. It's two men, Adam and Christ, the first Adam, the last Adam. So we've got to graduate and understand where we're at with the holy God and how we can graduate from our sinful nature and come into a covenant with God. And it's not by any work of righteousness which we have done, but it's according to God's mercy that he saves us through the washing of regeneration through the Holy Spirit.
It's too loud, sir.
So I want you to be growing in yourself in the faith, okay? The most important thing is your eternal salvation. That outside of Christ, you're an enemy of God. Many of your parents have spent thousands for you to whore yourself out and call it drugs, sexual sin, perversion, and bring you into greater damnation. You're going to go out to this graduation, get parties, get drunk, smoke marijuana, keep damnation upon yourself. God, the holy God, watching everything you're doing. Right? We've got to bring these serious issues up, because God is angry with the wicked every day. A holy God is just in all of his works. He demands your allegiance to him. And many of us are thinking about these things. You've got all these other plans, all these other agendas. You need Christ. Jesus came to save sinners from God, from his wrath, and in him we can be redeemed and restored to God, to know him in eternal life, to love him, to understand the gospel is that you are guilty before God of all your sins and thought would it be, and the Lord Jesus came into the world to do the will of God, to obtain God unto death, even the death of the cross, and lay down his life as the substitute for the sin for his people bearing their guilt. That Jesus rose on the third day from the dead, conquered Satan's sin in the grave, and sat down at the right hand of God. To serve him, to love him, is why you're alive. Not about all these other temporal things. Okay, God is holy, and God is not mocked. It is in Christ that we can have life. Through faith alone in Christ. What are you going to do with all your sins, sir? So you get older in your 40s and 50s, you get a hard heart. Still cursing, swearing. So your kids are rebels against the parents if they don't talk about God. You never learned about God. The Bible is not too loud. With all that filthy music that blares our ears, all that stuff that's going to be going on in the games, people screaming in stands for other people. That's not, when it comes to the word, it's too loud because we don't want to hear the truth. We love sin. We want to hear lies. We want to hear what we want to hear. But when it comes to serious reality about God and his word, we think it's too loud. Imagine how loud it's going to be in hell for those who die in their sins.